Well, hey there, Center Point Church, Randy here. Welcome to my kitchen. I wanted to share something with you today, first by asking you a question. So what I want you to do is I want you to tell me, what do you think that this is? Yeah, I want you to say it out loud. What is this? Well, yeah, if you said pickle, you'd be right, because it's a pickle. At least that's what the jar says, right? But if you want to be really technical, this is actually not a pickle. That's right, this is. You see, it's actually the juice, the brine, the liquid that the pickle was in. That's actually the pickle. This is just a pickled cucumber. And we all know that pickles come from cucumbers, but this is actually the pickle. It's the water, the vinegar, the salt and pepper and spices, and of course, in case of this particular pickle, fresh dill. It's that liquid that is actually what we call a pickle. Now, where do we get that from? We go back to the earliest place where we can find talking about pickling, and it's in this recipe for pickles where the Greek poet talks about taking the vegetable and washing it first so that the impurities, the dirt, and the earth that was on it wouldn't spoil the preserved pickle. And then he talked about after it was washed, then it would be submerged for a certain period of time inside of a pickle. And this pickle would then start to transfer its characteristics. The cucumber would start to take on the character, the nature, the flavors, the nuance of the pickle. And then when you took the pickle out, it would be something new entirely, but it would also be preserved, lasting much, much longer than it would have had it not gone into the pickle. Now, what's really interesting about this is when you look at this early Greek writing, when he talks about washing the vegetable first, he uses a word called bapto. And that really means just to wash, to cleanse, to purify. And then when he says that you're dunking and immersing, he uses a word called baptizo. Baptizo, does that sound familiar to us? That's right, that's actually where we get the term baptism. Because when we talk about baptism in Christianity, we're talking about an immersion. We're talking about being soaked in of God's Holy Spirit. And so it's a really cool analogy, but really it's where that word comes from. We talk about how first we wash the impurities. And that's when we decide to believe in Jesus Christ and to accept the gift of his death on the cross, the washing of our sins, the cleansing of our sins, so that we can be preserved. And then that next step is baptism. Now, baptism doesn't save you, but it is part of that because it's our public profession of our salvation. It's telling the rest of the world, I belong to Jesus Christ. I commit myself to Jesus Christ. I no longer want to be this person that I was. I want to be something new entirely. It's telling others that I am going to immerse myself into His Holy Spirit. And when I come out, I am going to be someone who is no longer what I used to be, but someone who has the characteristics, the nature of Christ. That's what baptism is all about. Maybe you are ready to make that decision that you want to live for Christ and you want to be baptized. This is your night. This is where you can do that. Please go to cpchurch.net or call our office. We'd love to walk you through that because who knows? Maybe it's time to put yourself in a pickle.